Hello, everybody, and welcome to NASCAR.com GarageCam. Well, we're not in the garage yet, but we are at Dover International Raceway. And look at all these NASCAR fans lined up. Get some autographs here. And guess who's giving autographs here? It's Kyle Larson, one of many NASCAR drivers signing here as he walks into the garage. Larson, having a good time so far. I saw you stop here, and you've signed about like 50 autographs, man.
Yeah, I signed more than I did yesterday, that's for sure. But I don't know, Dover brings out a lot of fans, especially in the infield, so it's good.
So what about this place? Now you're not a, you're experienced now here at Dover, so you like this place a lot more?
It's hit or miss. It just depends on like how the racing is. It changes a lot of times. Sometimes we just run the bottom here, and sometimes we can move up. When it moves up, it's a lot of fun, but when you have to run the bottom, it's kind of miserable.
All right, you ever mess up signing an autograph?
Yeah, a lot. Like yesterday, I misspelled one of the person's names. I had to write a whole new autograph.
Well, you know, our Chuck Bush, see you, buddy. Our Chuck Bush right here loves to misspell things. Chuck Bush without a C, by the way. Well, everybody, this is a fun start to GarageCam today. The show that's wild, it's wacky, it's live, it's uncut, it's raw. If you're new to the show and you're looking at the video here walking into the garage, look to the right. See that little chat room there? Well, get in that chat room, tell us who you are, where you're from, what you want to see today on NASCAR.com GarageCam, and we'll do our best to talk to drivers and have some fun here on GarageCam.
I was going to say, speaking of spelling, this guy right here was 3 for 3 in our spelling bee on NASCAR.com.
Yes, a champion spelling bee competitor right here, Michael Annette, live on NASCAR.com. How you doing, bud?
Good, bud.
So can you spell sign-in?
What?
Can you spell sign-in?
Sign-in?
Yeah.
S-I-G-N space I-N.
Yeah, yeah. He wins.
He's a champion.
He's a champ. Yes. If you haven't seen the spelling bee video, go check out the F-Post, NASCAR spelling bee, basically. This spelling bee's going on, of course. It was on TV last night. We're all watching it. And this guy right here, Chuck Bush, did a great job with the F-Post. Hey, that guy.
The guy with the microphone.
And speaking of that guy, there is that guy, Casey Mears. If you're all Casey Mears fans here on NASCAR.com, there's your driver right there. We're going to hop, skip, and jump through this garage area, show you as many cars, as many stars as we can. It's a little loud during this garage cam, which, you know, if you're a fan of GarageCam, you know how unpredictable this darn show is. Well, it's loud, so we're having a hard time hearing, but we have great microphones and a wonderful audio guy, CJ Lattierzo, doing his best so you can at least hear me. But we'll try to talk to as many drivers as we can and help out some pit crew guys right here when we can, too. Keith working on that car, making sure that tire doesn't get away from him. Austin Dillon, the number 3 machine right here. And let's show you something on some of these cars. Some of the cars running an Autism Speaks sticker right here on their cars. Several drivers flying the Autism Speaks colors, including Austin Dillon. And this Gil Martin-led team, the number 3 with a patriotic paint scheme this weekend. Pretty cool. Proudly supporting our veterans. A list right there on the back of that car. #Speed3Glory. Check it out. If you're on Twitter, make sure you use the #GarageCam, and I'll answer you. I'll talk to you on there, because we love answering questions. And Rashawn Brown is doing his best manning the chat room right now on our Sprint tablet. So is William Yeager right here. That's our Sprint tablet right there. And we're looking at the chat room right there, and so many in there. Aaron Luttrell, pole position for Aaron Luttrell. First person in today's interactive garage. Hey, can I see my favorite driver, Dale Jr., feeling weird because I don't know if I passed my test I just took. Well, we hope you passed your test as we look at Ricky Stenhouse's car, Aaron. So, and we're glad you're watching. You're decompressing from that test.
I wonder if the test was a spelling bee.
Was it a spelling bee, Aaron? We would like to know. Well, if you guys have a question, well, we like it on Twitter if it's any time. But right now, get in that chat room. Give us a question. Maybe Rashawn Brown will see one of those questions, pass it along for us or for your favorite driver. But pass one along to us, because we can't guarantee who the heck we're going to see. You don't know if you're going to run into Jeff Gordon, Dale Jr., David Gillen, heck, anybody. Ricky Stenhouse, you don't know. Or Chuck Bush.
I've got a question for you.
Okay, go for it.
We got, you know, a pet store thing right here. What's the airspeed velocity of an unladen swallow?
I believe it's 45.7.
Very good. Is that an African or a European swallow?
That's a European, of course.
Okay, all right.
Denser
course,
air.
Yes.
Yeah, humid. Anyway, Justin Allgaier right here. That was the most random question ever. So, fans, if you have a random question, let's hear it. The number 51 of Justin Allgaier. And check this out.
You.
Somebody here wants to say something.
Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. What'd you say?
I said, let's go, Rangers.
Oh, no, we don't want to talk to you. There's Dillner and R. Jr. doing the old walking sign right here. You know, I'm talking to him a few years ago. He said that's his favorite way to sign an autograph, actually, is the walking sign. Trevor Bayne, the number 6 car right here, Avocare on board. Going back to his primary paint scheme this weekend. David Reagan in the Aaron's Dream Machine, number 55 Toyota. Tony Stewart, a 2-time winner here, I believe. The Mobile One car. Of course, Mobile One, our proud sponsors here of NASCAR.com GarageCam. So give them a shout out whenever you can for support of your show. This is a fan show right here, GarageCam. Oh, gotta love that sound right there as Russell and the boys push this car and back it up in these tight confines here. This garage area here, if you've never been to Dover, very narrow it gets through here on this backside right here. When you come in from the track, you come in right over there, or even if you're on the front side, you have to drive right through here. And boy, does it get narrow right here, because we have trailers on the left, cars on the right, traffic, crew guys. It gets kind of crazy. What's up, Martin Truex? Chuck spotted him, but it was too late. Martin Truex, of course, winner here in 2007. The place where he got his first career NASCAR Sprint Cup Series win. Oh boy, and I'll tell you what, that 78 has been fast the last 2 weeks. Basically, the fastest car on the track. A lot of people say should have won the last 2 weeks, but you know, strategy and things just don't work out. That's racing, not always the fastest car that's in victory lane. Jim Lees, please show my homeboy Truex from the Jersey Shore right there. And there is Jersey Shore doing a little fist pumping. Come on, Philly, give him a little fist pump, Philly. Come on, no fist pumps from Philly over there. Front row Motorsports, Cole Witt right there with the blank, 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 blank white car. No sponsorship on that car except for a little speed stick on the top of the C post. We talked about the C post. Make sure you check out the F post. 2 videos this week. Whoa, overachieving right there. That's the A post. This is what we call the A post, folks, on a race car. This is the B post. This is the C post. And this is the F post.
Yay.
So make sure you check it out, the Spelling Bee piece, and a softball piece.
A recap of the Dover Pocono softball game.
Since we are in Dover.
Yes.
And I was on the Pocono team, Team Triangle, baby.
How'd that work out for you?
Dover, he was on the monster team because he looks like a big hairy monster.
Hey.
Hey, you know. And I didn't suck as bad as I thought I would.
It's true. But you did, you hit into a double play.
Yeah, and the worst part about hitting into a double play is, guess who turned the double play?
Joey Logano. Joey Logano, 2-2,
turn
2.
How did Joey Logano turn 2 on me?
Because you hit it.
Am I that slow?
Hey, you know, anyway. Speaking of slow and not slow, turn around because you got Kyle Busch right behind you.
Oh, yeah, there's a guy who's a lot faster than me. It's Kyle Busch walking through the garage, giving us a wave right there. I am pretty slow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Here's a guy, David Reagan, that was in our Spelling Bee piece. What's up, man, here in Dover?
Yeah, Dover, Delaware, ready to rock and roll. This is a fun place, track.
Did you watch the actual – we put you on our NASCAR Spelling Bee last week on the F post, the video posted the other day, but did you actually watch the Spelling Bee at all last night?
I did not. I was out playing golf with our friends with Fox Sports and hanging out and was late, but I saw a lot of people tweeting about it when I got back here to the racetrack, and man, some of those words are just impossible. And I'm glad to see some other drivers miss carburetor. I'm not the only one.
Hey, real quick, that charity event yesterday, the fans that are watching this that may not know about it, tell us about it.
Yeah, so Artie Kempner, I guess he's the director of the NASCAR on Fox, and he does some of the NFL on Fox, and he's got a son with autism, and you know, this weekend is Autism Speaks, I think 400, that FedEx really is a big part of. And so a lot of the NASCAR drivers go up there, but Artie does a great job with trying to raise some money for the autism community, certainly here in the Delaware area where he lives at. So a lot of the NASCAR personalities and different sports personalities come up, and I'm not a big golfer, but I go up and knock the ball around a little bit and have some fun. And my team owner, Michael Waltrip, was up there, and Daryl was there. So we hung out a little bit, raised some money for autism, and I'm sure they'll have a big presence here this weekend in Dover.
All right, he says he's not a big golfer or a big speller, but he's a big racer right there. David Reagan, the Aaron's Dream Machine driver.
Oh. Only three people got carburetor right.
Well, there's no more carburetors on these cars, so a guy like Alex Bowman, well, he's used to EFI now.
Yeah, that's true.
So, but Alex Bowman didn't do too well in the spelling bee as well.
He got two out of three.
We tried to get Matt DiBenedetto, but he couldn't spell any of the emails to us back, so we didn't understand it. No, just kidding, Guido. Matt DiBenedetto right here, the number 83 BK Racing entry. You see the name right there. Beloved Guido right there on the side of that car. Brian Scott taking a turn in the RCR entry this weekend, one of his few cup starts this year planned in that number 33. Sponsored by Kraft. That's pretty cool. Kraft on the side of that car and Acme. Acme, is that like the Roadrunner?
I hope it is.
Like, are we going to see
awesome.
Wile E. Coyote around?
Yeah. No, I'm going to be on the lookout. I feel like we would have seen him in Phoenix.
Yeah, he would have. If so, he would have dropped off the cliff. Yeah. Oof. Anyway, Mike Lynette, we saw him just a little while ago on NASCAR.com. GarageCam.
You know, according to CJ, Acme is a grocery store.
Oh, Acme is a grocery store. Okay, Acme grocery store.
Which would explain the Kraft singles.
Yes, Kraft singles. So it has nothing to do with Wile E. Coyote. Austin Dillon walking. Austin Dillon's got a new haircut, looking kind of spiffy, isn't he?
Yeah, it's sort of that high and tight with a little bit longer on the top.
I got a haircut this weekend, but it sucked.
It's kind of like yours, but yours is a little bit more awkward than
mine
his.
Mine is terrible. Terrible. It's awful. Anyway, you hear that loud noise right there. It's JJ Yaley cranking it up here in the NASCAR Spring Cup Series garage, and I got to cut my hand so you can even hear me here. But you know what? Would you rather hear race car or me? Race car. I choose race car.
I vote race car too.
Oh, JJ Yaley right next door here in the garage area. We're going kind of in the reverse order, but it's just the flow of the garage here. Every garage is different. That's why every garage camp is pretty much different. And because this is an unscripted show, you just never know who we're going to talk to either. Mike Bliss is number 32 machine right here, right alongside the Maxim.com Fantasy Sports number 26. Of course, I love playing fantasy sports. Maxim has a good fantasy sports. Of course, NASCAR Live on NASCAR.com.
How's your NASCAR fantasy team doing?
Hey, my NASCAR fantasy team is doing like my performance on the softball field that you can watch on the FOS. Just as bad.
So there's like flashes of maybe 15 years ago you were good at it.
I was good the first year when we were on the show, but it seems like we're going to be okay now. Hey, so we're talking about your sponsor on the car, and at first I was referencing Wile E. Coyote because of Acme, but Acme is a supermarket and a grocery store, so I stand corrected.
Yeah, Acme is a great grocer here in the Northeast. We're proud to have them on board with Kraft. Kraft, of course, makes a lot of great products. So
I mean, who doesn't love cheese, brother?
Mac and cheese.
Yeah,
Kraft singles, Velveeta. It should be a good weekend. Proud to have them on both the Xfinity car and the Sprint Cup car.
So you got some good shoes on this weekend because you're going to need them.
Yeah, I'm gonna be doing lots of walking, lots of driving, lots of seat time, which is good.
All right, and a lot of interviews.
Yeah.
See you later, Brian Scott, the RCR driver. Hey, you know what? We got to show you this car right here because trying to make the field again this week is the number 39 entry of Travis Quapple. 45 cars on the entry list, including this red, white, and blue Chevrolet of Travis Quapple, the former Truck Series champion. You know, and two cars are going to go home. Let's see. I don't know who those two cars will be, but qualifying will be interesting. Jeff Green, the number 30 car, hoping that he is not one of those. Brendan Gaughan alongside of that Jeff Green number 30 machine. Oh, crank it up, baby. Crank it up. Eric Amarola walking through the garage area right here. Looking for his holler. Looks like he's looking around like he can't find it. It's over there, Eric. Here's Josh Wise right here. You know what? Let's stop Josh Wise because we haven't talked to him for a minute.
I can't hear anything down here. I'm ready to go.
I know you got to sign in, but your buddy right there, Landon Castle, ran 14 miles after the 600. You're a big physical fitness guy. Were you impressed?
I was impressed, absolutely. It's very cool.
Would you think of doing something like that?
Yeah, I would think about it. You know, we call those brick workouts. So we do like two workouts back to back. That was a pretty impressive brick workout.
Go work out to that sign-in. Josh Wise can't hear us, but what a good sport. What a good sport is Josh Wise. He's going to walk on down to sign in. Basically, all the drivers, when they get here in the garage area halfway, we got a double flag stand here halfway on garage cam. Basically, what you do is you walk into the garage, and before you can get in your car and actually go out on the track, you have to be signed in at the NASCAR hauler. The more you know.
Just like you can sign into NASCAR.com to play your fantasy games.
And if you want to be in that chat room right now, if you're watching this live,
sign in
like I signed in.
Before you can put a lap in the chat, you got to sign in. Boom. How's that for a connection?
And if you sign in early like Aaron, you get the pole position.
Yeah.
We're going to try to give some other shout outs here to some people that are in the chat room. Even if we missed your driver, we want to say as many people as we can here on the show. Here's a car that you need to watch out for this weekend. I'm just going to say it right now. A.J. Allmendinger, this 47 team, has really turned the corner over the last year or so, especially with that big win at Watkins Glen last year, making the chase. But this is a track that they have circled on their calendar. The 47, A.J. Allmendinger, performed very well here at the Monster Mile. So, folks, keep an eye on. We were talking about NASCAR fantasy. A.J. Allmendinger could be a sleeper driver in that mid-range pack as far as price is concerned on fantasy games for a really strong run this weekend.
You got that $100 budget, so you got to work the budget in your favor, and a driver like that can help you out a good bit.
And this driver right here is still pretty high priced in the game because at the beginning of the year, everybody thought he was going to win everything there is. But so far, a tough season so far for Kyle Larson. But I'm telling you, he will get it back on track. The Earnhardt Ganassi Racing team are very strong, so expect this 42 up front here as we carry along. Maybe a little sophomore slump, but that's okay. Not a big one, though. Michael Chesniak, hi, Matt. Please find Danica in her car for little Zoe. Thanks from Reading, Pennsylvania. Oh, we love little Zoe and love to give shout-outs to her. I hope you're feeling better. And we love all of our NASCAR fans. And Michael Chesniak, a very, very, very loyal NASCAR.com GarageCam fan, always on, always hitting me up on social media, too, and saying hi. We love doing that. And here is the number 16 of Greg Biffle. New paint scheme for Greg Biffle here with the safety clean colors on board. This yellow. So if you're looking for Greg Biffle this weekend, we know to, well, look for a yellow car now. A little odd. And here is Danica Patrick walking in the right side of her garage here. Looking at some Xfinity Series times. And Clint Boyer, the number 15 here. Right alongside. Oh, the man that won last week, Carl Edwards. And you know what? I think we could get in here and maybe talk to Carl Edwards real quick. Driver, the number 19. A big win, of course, last week. You see that win sticker right there on the car for Carl Edwards. And here's a guy with a big smile on his face right there in that car, Carl Edwards. And big smile on your face rolling into Dover, a place you've won. You had the win last week. A lot of fun now,
yeah.
Right?
Now we can just go race, have some fun. And it's cool to have that opportunity. I mean, my guys have been working so hard. Everybody's been doing a great job. And yeah, we just needed to win. It was nice. So really glad to be here. I love this place. It's so fast. It's so much fun. So hopefully we can run well.
Every time I come here, Bristol, when we used to go to Nashville, you always hear Concrete Carl.
Yeah.
You always have so many darn nicknames, and none of really 100% stuck. Right. What's your favorite? Do you have a favorite?
Nah, I get
just Carl.
I get Flipper, Cousin Carl, and Concrete Carl.
Your cousins like the cousin one.
Yeah, yeah. I got some other nicknames that you know,
depending
aren't
on
as
how
loving.
The race goes.
Yeah, from somebody. But you know, whatever. As long as we're fast, I don't care what they call me. It's been fun, man. This is it's cool. It's such a relief to get that win. It's fun.
All right, buddy. Thanks a lot. Enjoy yourself in practice. Carl Edwards right there. Always have a smile and always taking time for GarageCam and his fans here at the track. So many times we see him walking through a crowd, stopping, taking selfies with his fans. Very good to his NASCAR fan. Let's see. Richard Barris, shout out to Carl Edwards, pit crew. Great job last Sunday, and thanks for being on Race Buddy Cam. Yes, that's right. Race Buddy on NASCAR.com. Make sure you check it out. A great segue provided by one of our chat room fans. I love it. So we can talk about Race Buddy, because you can see the number 19 this weekend on Sunday. Tune in to Race Buddy on NASCAR.com. Watch the race on Fox, but tune in to Race Buddy to follow your in-cars, audio, all the stuff, live leaderboard, all that. But in Race Buddy, you can see this number 19 of Carl Edwards. You can see Jamie McMurray's number one, the number four of Kevin Harvick, the red hot driver this year from Bakersfield, California. Of course, the number nine car of Sam Hornish, Ricky Stenhouse. We saw that car on the other side of the garage. You'll see him on Race Buddy as well. And some guy named Dale Earnhardt Jr. Remember, Carl Edwards already has a win here in his record books here at Dover, hoping to get win number two. Denny Hamlin, of course, another guy that could hoist a monster here this weekend. He's got a Brickyard 400 trophy, but Paul Menard has never hoisted a monster over his head. He's probably hoisted a monster drink, but not a monster trophy. Eric Amarola's number 43 car right here. Hardworking crew. Say hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
Ryan Newman, multi-time winner here at Dover. Three times Ryan Newman has won here at the Monster Mile. Three times.
He's in the 3-1.
He's in the 3-1. So he's won three times. The 3-1 has won three times. That's amazing.
Yeah, that's a great stat right
that's
there.
That's a wonderful stat. Here's the number five car of Casey Kane. Right alongside this number 24 3M machine of Jeff Gordon, about to climb into his car here. And there is the number five of Casey Kane, right alongside Hendrick teammates right there. 17 wins here for Hendrick Motorsports as an organization here. 18 wins at Charlotte Motor Speedway, 17 wins here. You showed the ultimate dominance of Hendrick Motorsports across this sport. And this guy right here making his 45th career start at Dover this weekend. Fans will get a chance to see him here this weekend, and then one more time for Jeff Gordon. Of course, he was the pace car driver last week at the Indianapolis 500 before trucking on over and doing the 600. Thomas Neller, hello from Germany. Oh, yeah, baby. Hear it. Here it's 4:30 p.m. Oh. 4:30 p.m. an afternoon garage cam. Please see my favorite driver, Jeff Gordon. I love it. I love it. Any request from Germany is a good thing. Well, there is your favorite driver with 3M on the hood. Jamie Mack all in his car right now. Another guy flying the Autism Speak stickers on his number one machine. Matt Kenseth, the number 20 machine. The Jason Ratcliffe-led team. Of course, the big win in Bristol. See this right here? See this guy with a whistle? Well, he's just clearing some people out of the way so these crews can work. Brad Keselowski about to climb into his car. Window net's going up. I saw Joey Logano, but I don't think we're going to be able to get to Joey. His window net just went up. Kind of one of those things, you usually don't talk to a driver when his window net goes up. Here is Dale Earnhardt Jr., softball teammate on Team Pocono, Team Triangle. We lost, but that's okay. Make sure you check out the video. You see Dale Jr. swinging a bat. If you're a fan of Dale Earnhardt Jr., you've seen him turn a wheel. And now you can see him swing a bat. That's right, on NASCAR.com, the F-post. Check it out. We lost. I've got to paint the walls here at Dover. I don't know if Junior will come help me. He said he will. I believe it when I see it. Jimmy Johnson's car right here. You want to talk about success here at Dover. You talk. It starts and it ends right here with this number 48 machine. Jimmy Johnson, of course, a nine-time winner here at Dover. You look at the greats they have won here, and you can look at Richard Petty, who won the first race here in 1969. Seven-time winner Richard Petty here, and Bobby Allison, a seven-time winner. Well, Jimmy Johnson has blown that away last year with his ninth win here at the Monster Mile. Hoping to become one of only, I believe, five drivers to have 10 wins at a particular track. Only five drivers in the history of the sport have been able to do that. Dale Earnhardt Jr., and you see a few other cars in the garage area here before we get going. Matt Kenseth has his Apple. He's ready to go. I have Apple on my camera. Hey, we're not that far from the Big Apple. Okay, there's Apple Schmutz on my camera. There it is. There's the Apple remnants. Well, at least my camera will smell good now. Probably a lot better than me. Joey Logano right here, the number 22 car. That was hilarious, boys. You never know what you can see on GarageCam, including Matt Kenseth throwing an apple. Kurt Busch, the number 41 machine right here, getting ready to go. And this is a car to look out for this weekend. Martin Truex. I saw Ryan Truex earlier this week. But Martin Truex Jr., this 78 car has been fast everywhere we've gone this year, unloading off the hauler and the Cole Perrin-led team.
Hey, do you
they just need to get a win. And they've been so close, you can almost smell it. It's going to happen here. And you know what? This is a place where he can do it because he's won here before. 2007, Martin Truex Jr., his first career win in that Bass Pro Shops number one. Could it happen this weekend, Chuck Busch?
Do you think I could have sold that Apple on eBay? I just threw it away. I threw it away because I didn't want anybody to run over the Apple.
You didn't finish it?
No. I mean, I like NASCAR, but I don't think I'm going to eat after somebody else.
No.
It's not how I roll.
Well, if you look at the videos and stuff out there right now, young Keelan Harvick, the Apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
Good
segue.
Seeing
Keelan and Kevin driving around on the little trikes and all sorts of things in the shop, but this guy right here has the visor down, the window net up. The Ditec colors this weekend for Kevin Harvick, and new colors, so a few new paint schemes. We're seeing all sorts of new paint schemes on NASCAR.com and also seeing them all over the place with that the throwback paint schemes coming out for Darlington, so check that out too. So a lot of you diecast people and fans of different paint schemes, well, there you go. Ditec on board this weekend, and pretty cool different look for that Budweiser number four, the defending champion of the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series, the Roddy Childers-led team.
It's like when summer rolls around, you get all these nice new paint schemes coming out. So
just like you get nice new clothes.
Nice new clothes, nice new haircuts, new paint schemes.
New paint schemes. Well, this is one of my favorite paint schemes in the Cup Series garage. Why, Chuck? Because it's simple.
Simple is good.
Simple is good.
And just like you.
I'm not very simple, but there is Martin Truex Jr. Ready to go. Only moments here before we crank up these machines and we go out there for the first practice here at Dover for the weekend. Of course, this is a racetrack that's very much temperamental, a concrete surface, 24-degree banking here at Dover, and a very weather-sensitive track. So you'll see oftentimes, you know, if it's really hot here, the place could be pretty slick, or the place could have a lot of grip if it isn't. And then also, the rubber buildup on the track is key here. How the rubber actually adheres to the racetrack. Is it on top of the racetrack? Is it marbled up? Will it sink down into that concrete? That all depends. So this is a place here where the crew chiefs, like Todd Gordon over here, really make their living fine-tuning these machines, communicating with that driver. Because it's not just a notebook. It goes from the driver to the radio right there, to the crew chief, and then the crew chief has to dissect the information on how the car is handling from the driver. And it's all about communication. Who does it best? Who dials in their machine the best? Well, is he who's fastest here at Dover. Junior in the car. I bet you he's ready to get out there. He's won here before, Dale Earnhardt Jr. Trying to make it two this weekend, the Nationwide number 88 machine right there. Oh, crank them up, baby. Here we go. We're going to roll them out here for you live on NASCAR.com. About 1 minute until qualifying, practice starts here at Dover, waiting for the Kevin Harvick car to be the first one to roll out of these garage stalls, and then we could sign off here on NASCAR.com. GarageCam, Brett Keselowski in his car waiting to go as well. Jimmy Johnson not present here in the garage area yet. You know, we've seen that a few times from this 48 squad. Jimmy actually watching the beginning of practice at places like Bristol, another concrete surface, not a short track. That's a short track. This place, a mile and high banked. But we've seen that before from this 48 team where they like to kind of sit back and watch and see how things go in that first few minutes of practice and then hop back out there. You know what? This guy, you could say he doesn't need practice. Everybody does here to get their cars dialed in, but nobody gets around this place quite like the driver of number 48 right here, the Lowe's Pro Services machine. All right, the cars are starting to roll out right now. A little early is Jeff Green. Official making him park along the side right there. Joey Logano ready to go. Give you a peek inside that machine. I think Joey's waiting too, wondering why we're not going. Here we go. Whistle is blown. Practice is underway here at Dover. Make sure you tune in on Sunday for the FedEx 400 on Fox, on MRN, and of course Sirius XM Radio. Tune in to NASCAR.com for live leaderboard and all the videos, including Race Center this week, your pre-race show, and as they roll out here at Dover to tackle the monster, one of the most fierce tracks on the circuit. High banks, high speeds, concrete, and a big old scary monster. Who will hoist it in victory lane this weekend? Oh boy, we shall see. It should be interesting. And as these cars roll out here, the thunder of NASCAR, we'll sign off. Until next time, I'm Matthew Dillner, and we'll see you at the races.